Everybody, and thank you for tuning in today. The last few weeks I have gotten a few new magazines in my postbox, and I've also seen them all over Instagram. So I thought, in case you haven't bought any of them yet, I thought I would give you a review. So in case you are thinking about if you should get one of those, then maybe this can help you a little bit. Just a disclaimer, I love them all! And the three magazines that I will talk about today is Line, Pom Pom, and Making. So let's get started! The first magazine that I wanted to talk about is Line, and it is their second issue, and it's the spring and summer issue for 2017. The magazine is founded by two women based in Finland, and it has the subtitle Nordic Knit Life. The whole magazine is kind of based around this idea of a Nordic look and the Nordic design, which is perceived as very clear lines, and all the pictures have quite, the colors don't really pop, they're more of a little bit dove and a little bit more subtle. It has a really clear look and with a lot of white space, for example, on the pages, which I really like actually. It's a very, very, very pretty magazine, and if you look at it, you just feel like you really get swept into the mood that they want to bring across. So I think they're doing a really good job with that. I did some crunching of the numbers for you. I will look that up here from my screen. The issue has 122 pages, and it features 11 patterns. It has quite of, and it's only knitting patterns in this magazine, and it has quite of a great variety. There are 4 shawls, 3 cardigans, 2 sweaters, 1 pair of socks, and 1 dress. And on top of that, there is a weaving tutorial, several recipes, a travel guide to Helsinki, which I just showed you. They also do these cute collections where they gather several products, like this one, for example. The paper is quite thick and also very matte, so it has a very high quality feeling to it. And it's slightly larger or broader than an A4 size, which means that all of the pictures, as a lot of them are, on a whole page, that you can really see the details very, very well. The price of this one is 285 Swedish kronor, and I bought it at my local yarn shop here in Stockholm. 285, that would be around £25 or €29. So it is quite pricey, but for me this one feels like I really love the patterns. The whole look and the feel is more, it's more like a book actually. It's maybe not a magazine where you get each issue. So I think also, although it's very pricey, I just wanted to have it, and I'm really happy that I got it. And it felt like one of these magazines. Sometimes I buy books or magazines and then I have a look and then I just put them into my shelf. But this one was really one that I read a lot, and I also might knit one of the patterns. So it feels that it's already worth it. Lastly, I wanted to tell you my favorite patterns. And in this one, it is the Ucho dress by Anki Strick. And it's a kind of a plain dress in stockinette stitch, and the sample is knit in Tuku wool, which it's a Finnish wool, and I have been thinking about trying it. So the only things that I dread knitting so much stockinette in a fingering weight. But I really like it, and on my Knitolutions for 2017, I said that I wanted to knit a dress. So you will see what happens. Second magazine, Pom Pom Quarterly, and this one is their 5th anniversary issue. So this one is a little bit special because it has more patterns than a normal issue of Pom Pom Quarterly has. I have been a subscriber since 2014, I think, and I really like their patterns. When I look at the garments that I have knitted, there are so many pom-pom patterns, so it feels like it's really worth it. So they made a large issue with all of the designers that they have been working with throughout the years, and asked them, and also their favorite yarns, and they asked them to design new patterns for this very full-packed and thick issue. So I have been looking at the numbers again. This issue has 149 pages and it features 16 patterns. That is one cardigan, four sweaters, three hats, two pairs of socks, one pair of mittens, two scarves, one shawl, one cowl, and one top. And it also has a few articles and a recipe, and it has, which a lot of pom-pom issues have, a graphic novel. So there's this beautiful graphic novel which describes the production of black yarn Samite, which I think is really, it's really beautiful. So it's a treat, I'd say. In comparison to Line, this just the format of the magazine. This is much smaller, it's a little bit larger than an A5. The quality of the paper kind of is the same. This is maybe, the paper is maybe a little bit thinner, but it also has a matte feel and look to it. And it also smells good, in case you smell your magazines as well. I didn't smell the other one. Anyhow. Just overall, I think the difference between those two is that, as you can also already see by the cover, Pom Pom is, they're really colorful, whereas Line, especially in this issue, has more like this romantic and the Nordic and clear feel to it. Pom Pom is more like colorful and extravaganza, and I mean, this is a special party issue, so it has more of a party feel to it. But if you have a look at the pages, it's a lot of colors and playful designs. And if you have a look at all of the issues, they differ quite a lot from issue to issue. But this one is a colorful one. The price of this one is £9.50. Which is 106 Swedish kroner or 11 euros. So this is almost a third of Line. And of course this is a special one because it has more patterns than the usual issues. But if you just would have a look at the patterns, then Pom Pom is more, it has a, in that case, a better value for money. But I still think that if you compare those two, Pom Pom focuses more on just the patterns than Line does. They have two articles in this one as well, and they have in all of their issues. But in Pom Pom, it really is the pattern, so it feels more like a pattern collection. Whereas Line more has also, it has more contents than just the knitting patterns. And my favorite pattern from Pom Pom is Knees Up by Juju Vale, which is a sock pattern actually, which is a little bit surprising because I don't always are too fond of knitting socks. But I found them really interesting because they have the foot itself is knitted in a fingering weight yarn, and then the shaft is knit in a DK weight yarn and is more slouchy. You could wear them with boots, and then you have still have a fitting foot, but then the shaft of the, it looks more like a leg warmer maybe. That's something I really like. It's such a brilliant idea, I think. The third magazine that I wanted to talk about is the third issue of Making, which has the title or the topic Dots. And the magazine is founded by a designer called Carrie Bostick Hoag, and she's based in Maine. So this particular issue is, as I said, has the topic Dots, and it also is inspired by indigo So the whole book is held in the blue and white and a little bit of turquoise color scheme, which is really beautiful, I think. And if you compare making to both Line and Pom Pom, I think the largest difference is that both Pom Pom and Line have knitting patterns exclusively. I think there could be a crochet pattern in Pom Pom, I'm not really sure. But making is not only knitting, even though they have a lot of patterns, but it's more everything that you could make. So it has embroidery, weaving, quilting, sewing, and knitting, of course. Here it also has a coloring sheet, for example, which I think is a fun idea. It's a little bit more diverse, which I wasn't really aware of when I ordered it, but I really like it. It's before I bought it, I thought I will mostly be interested in the knitting patterns, but it's such an inspiration to see all of the other projects that you can do, so I got really inspired. Some numbers: making has 153 pages and it has 14 patterns, and that is 4 cardigans, 1 pair of mittens, 1 sock pattern, 1 toy. It's a super cute giraffe. Oh, so adorable. 4 shawls, then 1 home accessory. It has a pattern for how to crochet around pebbles. I just realized that there are missing some they're missing some patterns here on my list. But anyhow, it has 14 patterns in general. And these were only the knitting patterns. So in making, there is, as I said, the pattern. So here it was the giraffe. Then here's a tutorial for how to make needle felt balls. It has a tutorial for Dorset buttons. Then it has a sewing tutorial for a skirt, for a wallet, as I said, some embroidery. So it's really, really diverse and mixes a lot of different handicrafts, which I think is such a beautiful idea, that you would take all of these different crafts and organize them around one topic. The price of this one is $24, which are 210 Swedish kroners, or €21.50, so it's also on the pricier range. But I mean, as all of these magazines, it also, if you have a look at it, it is more like a book. Oh, and I forgot to mention, my favorite pattern from making is the Hope cardigan by Amy Christophers, which is a cardigan worked sideways and has like this lovely lace pattern on the arm, which I thought is really beautiful. As I said, I wanted to tell you which one was my favorite, and I can't decide. Before I started filming the video, I thought that I would tell you that Line is my favorite, but now when I talked about making a lot more, maybe, I think it really depends what you expect, and maybe a summary of this could be: Line is very visually appealing, very dreamy and romantic, with very nice patterns. Pom Pom has this more colorful, playful approach in their magazines and is a collection of their patterns and their best designers. And then making is, or was for me, the source of inspiration for different crafts around one topic. So even though I couldn't decide, I hope this helped you a little bit in case you are considering buying any of these magazines. If you want to get updated about which videos I will upload, I would be very happy if you would consider subscribing to my channel. And I will also link some other videos from my channel that you can check out. And I will see you next Wednesday. Thank you. Bye bye.